My name is Dewan Farmer. I'm a postdoctoral fellow at the Crump Lab. I am the recipient for the Hanna H. Gray Fellows Program, which is sponsored by the Howard Hughes Medical Institute. And so what that does is it provides you 8 years of funding for 4 years as a postdoctoral fellow and 4 years as an early investigator, early independent investigator. As someone underrepresented in the sciences, it's great to begin to establish a community where you see people like yourselves achieving at a high level. And the HHMI Hanna Gray Fellows Program really immediately connects you with this diverse group of people who are really doing exciting research. And so that's one thing I think that's amazing for my future, to be able to see that diversity in the sciences at a more intimate level. I use zebrafish to understand skeletal stem cells, and specifically I use a model of disease called craniosynostosis to understand how the bones that form our skull develop, but also how during disease how they become dysfunctional and fuse prematurely. If you could think about when you have a baby, they usually have these soft spots, and the skull isn't fully formed because it needs to accommodate the ongoing growth of the brain. And in craniosynostosis, these bones will prematurely fuse together, and as a result, the brain will continue to grow, and you have all these different malformations of the skull shape. So the most dangerous aspect is that they have increased intracranial pressure, and so which means there's not enough space for the brain to grow, and that can lead to mental retardation. And as a result, because it has a potential to cause mental retardation, they have to go through really invasive and extensive surgeries to separate the skull bones to ensure that you can accommodate the ongoing growth of the brain. At a biomedical level, we can begin to understand how we can best treat and repair patients with craniosynostosis by understanding the fundamental features of what makes a skeletal stem cell a skeletal stem cell. And then at a more basic level, we can begin to understand what is the diversity of stem cell populations that exist along the lifetime of an animal or a human, and what are the distinct needs of a stem cell over time. I think I always had an affinity for science, and particularly biology from a young age. That was probably reflected in interest in like insects or like, you know, chemicals and things you shouldn't be doing sometimes as a child. And so you can be your most creative self and your most ambitious and, you know, discovery oriented self in an academic setting. And that's where I want to be. I want to be able to discover things and go different places that I didn't expect to go and learn really, you know, really exciting new things about biology. And I think academia is the place to do it.